In its first flight, the E-series Gripen took off from Saab's airfield in Linköping, Sweden and flew over Östergötland for about 40 minutes before landing. During the flight, a number of systems were tested, including landing gear, Swedish website Kron reported. The Gripen E's first flight was initially scheduled for late 2016, yet was delayed for 6 months to allow Saab to fine-tune its software. In May, company officials called the decision right as it allowed them to have more time to ensure that all risks had been eliminated. "Today we have flown this world-class fighter aircraft for the first time. We achieved it with the fully qualified software for the revolutionary avionics system. We are about to give our customers a smart fighter system with the future designed in from the start," Jonas Hjelm, Saab's head of the aeronautics business unit, said in a statement. The Gripen E is an advanced version of earlier Saab fighter jets. Compared with Gripen CD, the length of the EF version has been increased from 14.1 to 14.9 meters, the wingspan from 8.4 to 8.6 meters, the maximum starting weight from 14 to 16.5 tons and the weapons capacity with 1.5 tons. The range has been extended with 40% bigger internal fuel tanks. Also, the engine is 22% stronger, while the radar and the warning system have become more nuanced. As the maiden flight took place shortly before the start of the Paris Air Show, which starts today, Saab might have obtained a trump card for its meetings with prospective buyers. As Saab officials previously indicated, future tenders in Belgium and Finland were considered to be potential opportunities for the Gripen E. Of yet, the Swedish Air Force is expected to become the foremost Gripen user, having committed to a purchase of 60 models. Meanwhile, Brazil is on order for 36 jets, including 8 twin-seat F versions. Deliveries to both Sweden and Brazil are slated to start in 2019. Earlier in June, Brazil confirmed its plans despite the ongoing recession, rampaging unemployment, political turmoil and vague economic prospects. Previously, though, Brazil was reported to have a need for 100 aircraft, which is why a question mark was put to the extension of the Brazilian order. "We are only at the beginning of our cooperation, but there is no doubt that this opens up huge opportunities in the future, not only for Brazil but also for other countries in South America," Brazilian Defense Minister Raul Jungmann told the Swedish daily Svenska Dagbladet. While Brazil may seem the largest export market so far, it may be still overshadowed by India, which previously voiced plans to procure over 100 planes to the tune of $20 billion. Botswana, whose president Ian Khama today arrives in Stockholm to negotiate a highly controversial deal with Saab, may become yet another prospective Gripen user, Dagens Nyheter reported. Botswana is poised to buy 8 Gripens of previous generations to the total cost of $1.6 billion, which triggered protests from the country's opposition and was predicted to incite an arms race in the region. Despite its image as an international peacemaker, Sweden is one of the world's largest arms exporters per capita, selling arms to the tune of 11 billion sk, $1.3 billion, in 2016.